It was a confession that sent shockwaves for many reasons, one of which is how it painted the president as someone who was willing to circumvent the process just to get himself and his family inoculated ahead of everyone. Joining us now, the confessor, Manila Times columnist Montulfo. He's also the Philippines' special envoy to China. Ambassador, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
All right.
For the invitation.
Two confessions that you made. One, that you were inoculated and that you have applied to be the distributor of Sinopharm here in the Philippines. I want to ask you first, what was the reason behind this so-called confession, Ambassador?
I wanted the public to know that Sinopharm was very effective. I was applying to become a distributor here in the Philippines.
So that was your only reason. You wanted the public to know. But isn't that in itself, at the very least, unethical? Because in your column, you wrote about the efficacy of Sinopharm. You wrote about the glowing reviews it has received. Yet in the end, you said that you were applying to be a distributor of the said vaccine here in the country. How is that not unethical at the very least, Ambassador?
Are you saying that it's unethical because I'm special envoy to China?
Well, in on so many levels, that's one. And number two, as a journalist, you are sort of endorsing this Sinopharm vaccine only to say later on that you're actually applying to be a distributor of the vaccine.
Yes, I did apply. In fact, my application is still in the process of being accepted. And the company that's that I applied with is also the application is still pending with Sinopharm.
So pending or not, is that not unethical, Ambassador?
I don't see anything wrong with it, because I was doing it as a private citizen, not as a special envoy or a government official. And remember that special envoy is a is an honorific title. It's not. I don't receive any compensation from the government.
But would Sinopharm have talked to you or entertained your queries regarding being a distributor had you not been a special envoy of the Philippines to China?
I've never had any direct dealings with Sinopharm. I only had direct dealings with a local distributor here, or the local company that wants to distribute the vaccine.
How sure are you that, first of all, who initiated the communication between you and the local representative of Sinopharm here in the Philippines?
You know, I heard that Sinopharm and the local representative or the local distributor here in the Philippines were negotiating for the vaccine, and I applied with a company. In the event that the deal pushes through, I would be given the priority.
Mm. And do you think that they would have given you the light of the time of day had you not been a special envoy of the Philippines to China?
I said I never had any direct dealings with the Chinese government nor with Sinopharm.
Yeah.
I only dealt with a local company here.
Even so, do you think that they would have given you the time of day?
Yes.
Even?
Yes.
So you approached them as a private citizen, or did you approach them?
Yes, I approached them as a private citizen, not as a government official. And I never used my my position as special envoy to China in dealing with a private company here.
All right, because people are asking, how could you compartmentalize that? Montulfo as a private citizen, as a journalist, as a special envoy to China. You're only one person there, and you represent all these three.
As far as I'm concerned, I didn't commit any wrongdoing in having myself vaccinated.
All right. Here you are, though, a representative of the country admitting to using a smuggled vaccine. Tell us why you think you shouldn't be held accountable for, number one, violating the special counterfeit law. I mean, the compassionate use permit for Sinopharm was given post the inoculation of the PSG last September. Go ahead, Ambassador.
Mm-hmm. You know, I was not the only one who was vaccinated. There were other government officials who were vaccinated. And I'm sorry, I cannot reveal their identity. But before I got vaccinated, I learned that some members of the presidential security group had been vaccinated before me.
But you know what they're saying, Ambassador? It's not really the amount of people who got vaccinated ahead of the majority of the population. It's the very fact that it happened, even with a vaccination rollout that has yet to be rolled out. The fact that you went ahead and got yourself vaccinated ahead of the others, that's quite unethical, to say the very least. Ambassador, what do you say to that observation?
My intention was for me to know the efficacy of the vaccine. That's why I had myself vaccinated. If it was, for example, Pfizer that was being vaccinated illegally, I would not have applied for it, because I only applied for Sinopharm. And I took the opportunity of risking my life in getting vaccinated, because I wanted to know the efficacy of the vaccine.
But it was smuggled, Ambassador.
Yes.
And you don't see anything wrong with that?
I don't see anything wrong with it, because I was doing it as a private citizen, not as a government official.
Right. In an interview, Ambassador, you said that your title is just honorific and that you are not a government official. If you are not a government official, then what are you, Ambassador?
Special envoy to China.
And you think that doesn't hold any weight?
Special envoy to China is the president's personal representative to a host country, while the ambassador is the country's representative to a host country. That's why very specific. A special envoy cannot be addressed as ambassador. Only special envoy.
All right. So I'm going to correct myself. Special envoy Montufo, in that same interview, you said that you didn't find it irregular when asked if you found it inappropriate that the president was also asking for the smuggled vaccine. Why didn't you find this irregular? Is this normal occurrence in the palace?
I don't know, but I really don't find anything irregular about the president asking for vaccination, because his request could have gone through the FDA.
But Ambassador, we're talking about a smuggled vaccine here, and we're talking about basically using the position for personal gains. That's the issue here. You didn't find that irregular?
I don't find it irregular. I'm sorry.
All right. Now, the title of your column was Vaccine Arrival Delayed. Why did you stop? When you read through it, you sort of stopped short on putting the blame on anyone explicitly. Who are you blaming for the delay and why?
I would blame the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration, as well as our vaccine czar, who did not approve of the president's request to be vaccinated.
So that's the whole point of your, that was the whole point of your column, because
yes,
they
that
didn't.
That was the whole point of my column.
Because they didn't pander to the president's whims.
The president wanted sign the farm. His preference was to sign the farm, but Nuvez and the FDA would not have any of it.
Okay, so that's another story altogether, why people are just shaking their heads over your exposé, because it really painted, you know, this whole concept of a privileged few operating outside a government vaccination rollout campaign. And that leaves a distaste, you know, that leaves a bad taste in the mouth to a lot of people. The fact that here you are, you have government prepping the people for this vaccination campaign, and yet your expose basically detailing how the president just wanted this single vaccine for himself, and therefore the whole country should have it.
I don't find anything wrong with it.
Why? Why don't you find anything wrong with that?
Because the president would have, after, if the request was granted, he would have had the FDA approve it.
But there is no application coming from Sinopharm. Are you saying that the press...
I did know that.
Mm. Because there has to be a pending application.
I didn't know that I only know that there's a pending application by a local distributor here, mm. with Sinopharm through its subsidiary in Singapore.
Mm. All right. As a final question, Special Envoy Tulfo, why shouldn't you be held accountable for using your position, journalist,
never,
special envoy,
never,
or otherwise?
I never used my position as special envoy. I got vaccinated as a private citizen.
All right.
And a potential distributor.
And to the observation that your expose did more harm than good to the president, that you basically threw him under the bus, your reaction to that?
I don't know. I'm a journalist. I just wrote what the president told me.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Special Envoy of the Philippines to China, journalist Mon Tulfo, thank you for joining us today. Appreciate you taking our Zoom call. Keep safe.